Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dana and I am so excited to share my love of makeup and beauty with you all. Today I am back with new hair and new brows. Very excited to get back to filming. Today I thought I would do a video that is pretty requested in my sort of real life, which is sharing some tips for people who don't know much about makeup that want to start getting into it. So I've compiled my top sort of 10 tips for someone who is hoping to start getting into makeup but hasn't made the plunge just yet. So we'll count down from 10 to 1. So number 10 is skincare is vital. I really learned this kind of late in the makeup game, but healthy skin really genuinely does look and feel better. But healthy skin also makes it easier for makeup to be applied. Makeup applies smoother and more evenly, and it just looks you know, more like natural skin if it applies over healthy, well-treated skin as opposed to skin that's really dry or not well cared for. I am no expert on skincare. All I know is what I've tried and what's worked for me and what hasn't. So I'm not gonna try and, you know, give you guys advice on how to tackle your own skincare needs, but, you know, there's lots of amazing YouTubers that are well-versed in skincare and dermatology. You can also seek out advice directly from your dermatologist if you're looking to start a skincare routine. It doesn't have to be elaborate. You don't have to do the 35-step skincare thing, and actually most skin doesn't react well to that, but just find what works for you to treat your skin the best you can. Your makeup will look better. Number 9 is find inspiration. This is something I hear from my friends a lot, is that it's quite difficult to know where to start when you're just sort of looking at your bare face like a blank canvas. So I think it's a really, really good idea to try and find looks you want to try and copy first. It's easier to learn how to build a look once you've already sort of practiced with makeup, you've played with color, that sort of thing. So if you are sort of staring at your face and not sure where to start, finding inspiration is a great place. You can find a lot of Instagrammers or YouTube videos, even Pinterest has some great looks that make it really easy to just sort of find a place to start by copying a look you want to emulate and then learning how to build a look later. Number 8 is know your skin type. And this is really important for finding base products, cheek products, that sort of thing that's going to work well for you. You might have sort of tight, flaky skin that doesn't really get oily. You probably have dry skin in that case. You could have more oily skin, which gets very shiny throughout the day. You usually will have large pores on your cheeks, your nose, or your T-zone. You could have somewhere in between the two where you don't really get very oily or very dry, in which case your skin is usually considered normal. You could have combo skin where different parts of your face have different skin types. That's what I have. My chin and my cheeks are quite dry, whereas my T-zone, my forehead, and my nose are quite oily. And any skin type can also be affected by acne or sensitive skin, and it's really important to know if you have either of those as well. Most base products actually will tell you what they were meant for, but that doesn't necessarily mean you can't use them if you have a different skin type. It just means that you might want to pay a little bit more attention to the types of needs that you're looking to fill with that product. Number 7 is know your undertone. This is another one I hear a lot from my friends, is that they're not really sure how to find their undertone, and that can make it tough when you're shopping for foundation. Even lipsticks or eyeshadows can be tough. There are lots of websites out there that will help you, walk you through the process to try and figure out your undertone, but the two simplest ways are jewelry and veins. So if you look at the veins on the inside of your wrist here, you can usually see a couple poking through the skin there. If they are sort of greenish color, you're probably more warm toned. If they are purpley or light blue, you're probably more cool toned. And if you have like sort of a deeper blue or maybe even a teal, you're probably somewhere in the middle, a neutral skin tone. Now, not everybody will fit neatly with those categories, as color is a little bit subjective and it's hard to tell. So another good one is jewelry. If you prefer silver jewelry on your skin tone like I do, you're probably more cool toned. If you prefer true yellow gold, you're probably a warm tone. And if you can comfortably wear either, or if you prefer sort of a rosy gold color, you might be a neutral skin tone. That's gonna help you narrow down the types of foundations or the colors that you might wanna try on your skin, but it doesn't have to limit you with everything. It's just giving you a place to start. Number six is start with the products that make the biggest impact. So if you're just starting out with makeup, you're not really ready to do a full glam face, that's totally fine. And maybe you've been using makeup for a long time, but you don't want to do a full glam face, that's also totally okay. Minimalism in makeup is great. If you want to wear just a little bit, focus on the areas that are going to make the biggest difference. In my personal opinion, that would be brows, mascara, and blush. Blush can completely change your face shape. You can really sort of add depth and dimension. You can make your face look thinner, longer, wider, whatever it is you want to add. Blush can do that for you. Eyebrows really help to frame your face. They work really well to give your eyes some extra depth and dimension. And mascara helps to bring attention to your eyes without distracting from your face. In my personal opinion, those three are the most important and they make the biggest difference in a makeup look. So it's a great place to start. And then if you feel comfortable and you're interested, you can add more products to that group, but that would be where I would start. Number five is nowhere to save and nowhere to invest. The drugstore has amazing makeup products and they get better every year. Even some things that aren't really drugstore but are affordable, things like ColourPop, make some eyeshadows that are very affordable but are fantastic quality. So really, you don't need to spend a lot of money on products that you can find dupes at the drugstore for. In my personal opinion, you know, eyeshadow, lip glosses, mascaras, brows, there's not a lot of reason to spend a lot of money on those products because they're easily duped at the drugstore. Personally, I always buy high-end foundation, and that is just purely because I have really struggled to find a drugstore foundation that is light enough and cool-toned and works with my combination skin. Personally, I've never found anything in the affordable price range that does that. So I am willing to invest in better quality, high-end products for my foundation because I know it will work. And I think that's the same if you're just starting out with makeup. Don't run out to Sephora and buy everything high-end because you really don't need to. But if you're struggling to find something you like at the drugstore, consider whether it's worth investing for you in a more expensive product, because it might be. Tip number four is blend, blend, blend. Blending is your best friend when it comes to making a makeup look appear seamless and appear more experienced in application. You want to blend everything. And in my opinion, especially with lots of people who are new to makeup, you want to blend more than you think you should. Keep blending until you're happy with the result. If product blends away and it gets lighter and you didn't want it that light, you can easily add more product, but it's very difficult to take product away, especially on the eyes, and it can really throw off a look if you were trying to keep it a little bit lighter and you added too much. So start with less and blend, blend, blend. That will make your eyeshadow or your blush or whatever you're applying look more seamless. Tip number three is start with the staple tools. Personally, I don't find there to be a really substantial difference between most drugstore tools and most high-end tools. I think they perform fairly similarly, and you're gonna get pretty similar of a look between the two. But I do find there is a really big difference between using your fingers or those like gross little applicators that come in some eyeshadows versus an actual tool, a brush or a sponge. So in my opinion, invest in a couple staple multitasking type tools. Personally, for me, that would be a foundation sponge or brush, something I can use to blend both foundation and concealer, and even put on powder, I do it all with my same sponge. I also think a blush or contour brush is really important if you're planning on using blush or contour. It just makes it blend much smoother. And if you're going to do eyeshadow, I would say a big fluffy blending brush and a flat shader are the two most important. As you get better with makeup, as you get more experienced, and as you want to try different looks, you can absolutely add more specialized tools as you need them, but start with the basics. There's no need to rush out and buy a 40-piece brush set because chances are you won't use most of those brushes. Tip number two is start simple, but don't limit yourself. So looking for eyeshadow looks on YouTube or on Instagram that are titled easy or beginner is a really great way to practice and learn techniques. But don't feel like you have to stick to those. There's no reason that a beginner can't try something more advanced. It's makeup. It's not life or death. You can absolutely try something that's beyond your skill level. That's how we learn. That's how we grow. And this is essentially the best time to experiment, is find out what you like, find out what works for you. Starting with an easy, simple makeup look can be a great way to start practicing and learning techniques, but don't feel like you have to box yourself into the basics. You're allowed to experiment with whatever you want. And number one is practice does make perfect. If you want to get better at makeup, you have to keep applying it. Every time you put makeup on, you're getting a little bit better. And it's really important that if you want to improve your skills, you have to keep doing it. If you're self-conscious about your skills, you don't want people to see your makeup while you're trying it out and practicing, that's fine. Put your makeup on a day off where you're not going to go out anywhere, or put it on at night before you jump in the shower so you can wash it off right away. And then just keep practicing. Try new things. Try doing the same thing over and over again. That's the only way you're going to get better. So really, if you aren't happy with where your makeup skills are at the moment, or you just want to improve them a little bit more like I do, keep doing it. Try more. And then one bonus tip I would like to add, and this goes for everyone, not just beginners, but everyone in the makeup world, and that is don't listen to makeup rules. Really genuinely don't. When I was first learning to do my makeup, I remember being told so many different rules that blush had to be applied here because my face is quite round, or I needed a sharper brow arch because my face is round, or I couldn't wear blue or green eyeshadow because I have blue eyes. Don't listen to that. You don't have to do anything you don't want to do, and you are allowed to do things that aren't correct. There is no right way to do your makeup. It is entirely about what you like, what looks good on you, and what you feel beautiful in. If you like wearing the wrong color of eyeshadow, or you like to bring your blush farther down even though it emphasizes your round face, do it. You are allowed to do your makeup your way. So beginners, experts, everyone in between, don't listen to makeup rules. You are allowed to do what you want to do. So there you have it. Those are my top tips if you are just starting out in makeup and wanting to know how to get into it more. I hope these were helpful for you. And if you'd like to see more tips or recommendations on how to get started with makeup, let me know. I'd love to help you out. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.